Now, I knew that Brian Koberger didn't really fit this entire case, but now I think I know who does. Guys, I'm JB Gunner. This is JB Gunner TV. This will be the first time I'm going to be talking about Emma Bailey and Demetrius Robinson. I know other YouTubers have talked about it within the last month, but this will be my first time talking about it because I've let things play itself out, and I got to admit, there's enough here. I got to say, JLR sent me down a rabbit hole, and tonight I've been up all night kind of gathering all the information. Today we're going to talk about someone that could be my new suspect in the Idaho 4. We're talking about Demetrius Robinson. I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time. Let's get things going. Man, I know y'all was not expecting this video from me here today, but you're gonna get it anyway. Guys, I've got a pinched nerve, sciatica, or something, so bear with me. I am fucking miserable, but I'm gonna get you guys this video anyway. Guys, I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time. Before we get started, I want to say first and foremost, thank you to everybody that supports the channel, regardless of the method you choose, whether it's Cash App, Patreon, Venmo, PayPal. Truth is, guys, I couldn't do this each and every day as often as I do if it wasn't for you. So thank you guys so much for all your help and support. If you too find my content valuable, feel free to join the Gun Squad. Hit the links down below. And while you're down there, you can even find some of my other channels, my politics channel, my live stream channel. I wouldn't go there though if you're a snowflakey type person. It's not really for you. Maybe the gaming channel would be for you, or you can just stay right here. All right, now, look, man, from the beginning of this entire case, I told you I didn't feel right about Koberger. I have told you I didn't feel that Koberger was the guy. And even if he was the guy, I definitely felt like they didn't have enough evidence. Now, there's something that is confused me as I went down a rabbit hole last night, and it is why more people are not talking about the potential connection with Emma Bailey and Demetrius Robinson. Now, a lot of us have said from the very beginning there could be very much so a drug aspect to this case. We've talked about Xana's dope fiend mom. We've talked about the house being a party house. We have talked about even the fact that Brian Koberger is a former heroin addict, right? We've talked about all these things, but nobody's really pointed out the actual drug dealers in the vicinity. All of you guys have talked about Enon Harsh, and for whatever reason, you think that little hippie is the guy that did it. I don't know. That's on y'all. But not many people have discussed Emma Bailey and, most importantly, Demetrius Robinson. Let's go ahead and get into this, though, because I'm going to show you some of the things that I have picked up. Now, let me go ahead and tell you where there is a potential connection. There's a couple of them right off the jump. I'm going to tell you how these two people came into this story at all. I'm going to tell you maybe a little bit where they connect. But in case you guys are new here, we're talking about the Idaho 4 murders, the four college students murdered on King Road on the night of November 12th, 2022. Big, brutal murder, and a lot of us believed from that from the very beginning that there may have been needed to be two people or so. Now, I'm not one of these people that believed it was six people, seven people, the entire fucking fraternity, anything like that. But a lot of things here make sense. Because when we talk about stuff as perhaps these ladies right here, we all said that they were highly attractive. Emma Bailey is actually highly attractive. Demetrius Robinson, I'm going to go out on a limb and say, is a pimp. And I'm going to show you some of that right now as we proceed. Because as I'm someone, I literally got pimping 24/7 on my hands. Someone raised by a prostitute. Someone had a hoe as a sister. I got into the game myself, moving some females around when I was younger. I kind of understand the game. Many of you have even theorized that these girls right here had OnlyFans pages. I just want to throw that out there because I want to connect some of that. When Brian Koberger was arrested, he asked if anyone else was arrested. Now what we're going to do is we're going to talk about a woman by the name of Ashlyn Couch. From what I understand, this is Maddie's old roommate. Ashlyn Couch's best friend is Emma. Now, we'll let that slide for just a small second here. But there's also other things that could potentially connect this. Bottom line is, these two people are drug dealers. Bottom line of this is, Demetrius Robinson has been very, very violent in his history, including with women, and I'm going to show you that as well. Bottom line is, Emma lived 3 minutes away from the Idaho 4 murder house. Bottom line is, Emma actually used to DoorDash. Bottom line is, Jack in the Box told JLR that the DoorDash driver had black hair. Starting to add up yet? It will, hopefully, by the end of this. We're going to be talking about two people in custody over after man dies of apparent overdose in Centralia apartment. As you see this beautiful Emma woman and this Tyrone right here. We'll just kind of move on past Ebony and Ivory for just a second. Two people were arrested on drug offenses after law enforcement connected them to the overdose-related death of a 22-year-old man in Centralia on Tuesday. Officers with the Centralia Police Department responded at about 9 a.m. on March 21st. This is back on March 21st when they were arrested. To report that the man, who was found by his friend in an apartment in the 3000 block of Borst Avenue, was unconscious and not breathing, according to a news release from the police department. According to the friend, the man was visiting the University of Idaho in Moscow and had attended a party in Seattle the night prior, where he overdosed. Interesting. Tell me more. He received care at Harborview Medical Center before he was discharged at about 2 a.m. and picked back up by the friend, by the way, who lives in Centralia. The friend told law enforcement the man went to sleep and stopped breathing shortly before the friend called 911, according to court documents. Sorry about that. The man's official cause of death has not been released. When a preliminary investigation revealed illegal drug use was involved in the man's death, Centralia detectives launched a controlled substance homicide investigation, according to a news release from the Centralia Police Department. Due to the suspicion of fentanyl being involved, detectives requested assistance from the Joint Narcotics Enforcement Team, according to the news release. The poisonous effects of fentanyl are killing individuals and devastating families. With the recent amounts of deadly fentanyl that have been seized in our area, the Centralia Police Department and JNET have made it a priority to not only reduce the manufacturing, distributing, and transporting illegal drugs and guns within our community, but to also identify and arrest all subjects who were involved in the delivery of illegal drugs like fentanyl. While law enforcement officials suspect fentanyl was involved, the two people arrested Tuesday identified as Emma Bailey, age 22, of Moscow, Idaho, and Demetrius R. Robinson, age 36, of Tacoma, Washington, are accused of delivering cocaine to the man shortly before he overdosed at the Seattle party. Because fentanyl, a highly addictive synthetic opioid 50 to 100 times stronger than morphine, it's cheaper and more addictive than most controlled substances. It's frequently mixed into other drugs, including cocaine. At the request of detectives, the man's friend sent a social media message to Bailey. Check this out. And attempted to ruse her into a meetup to purchase more dope. But Bailey allegedly advised she was not willing to sell, that the man had died in D's arms, D being Demetrius, and the man needed to get healthy. So apparently, it looks to me like D, and maybe even Emma, was the person who took him to the hospital and maybe even went and picked him up afterwards. But either way, Emma seems to be able to make the drug dealing choices for the couple. When law enforcement located Bailey and Robinson at a residence in Idaho, they reportedly found some loose white powder substance, several hundred dollars in cash of small bills, assorted size of small baggies, small bottles of white powder vitamins, and empty capsules in a bag sold for the purpose of self-loading, according to the court documents. Bailey and Robinson were booked into Lewis County Jail at about 10 p.m. on Tuesday. They're each charged with one count of conspiracy to commit a violation of the Uniform Controlled Substance Act in Lewis County Superior Court on Wednesday. The charge is considered a Class B felony with a maximum penalty of 10 years. Bail was set at $100,000 each on Wednesday. They have arraignment hearing set for Tuesday, March 23rd, which I believe they are still currently in there. Now, when it comes to this area, we can look at the county jail. And if you look at the county jail, they are both still listed as inmates. As you can see right here, Emma Mae Bailey, her number is 386-300, March 21st, 10:05 p.m. And we scroll on down here to the S's. Excuse me. We'll find Demetrius here. What was his name again? Demetrius what? Motherfucker. Give me just a second. Losing my shit. Demetrius Robinson. I'm sorry, we gotta go to R's, not S's. Demetrius Rennell Robinson. 2386301. So both parties are still currently incarcerated in the Lewis County Jail, according to jail records. Now, let's go ahead and get back. We'll just finish the story now when it comes to that. Now, you may say to me, JB, what does any of this have to do with anything? Now, remember, we initially thought the drugs could be involved. Now, we're going to continue here because I'm going to continue with a little bit of background on what's going on. Now, earlier I watched a video by JLR, and this is what sent me down this rabbit hole. And throughout this research, I've been able to notice the history of Demetrius Robinson. Demetrius Robinson, State of Washington versus Demetrius R. Robinson. I want you guys to go ahead and check out what occurred here. This is in 2018. Mr. Robinson spent the afternoon with Bright Johnson drinking beer and spending time at two different apartment complex pools. Later in the evening, the two joined several other friends and acquaintances and went to various private parties around Pullman. Pullman, remember that name. The group eventually returned to the indoor pool area located at the Campus Commons Apartments on the early morning of July 8th. Mr. Robinson had plans to meet up with his friend Madison Geidel. When Mrs. Geidel arrived at the pool and saw Mr. Johnson, she retreated to her car and called Mr. Robinson, who came outside. Mr. Geidel informed him that the night before she had been at a party where Mr. Johnson groped her, and seeing him gave her a panic attack. So she set this motherfucker up. You're about to see. Gave her a panic attack. Ms. Geidel left, and Mr. Robinson, who was visibly frustrated, returned to the pool to find Mr. Johnson eating Mr. Robinson's food. This motherfucker ate his food and shit. Mr. Robinson angrily confronted Mr. Johnson about eating his food, and Mr. Johnson got into the hot tub. Mr. Robinson kicked a cell phone charger into the pool and asked Mr. Johnson to get in the pool and retrieve it. Mr. Johnson entered the pool where he had difficulty retrieving the charger from the bottom of the pool. While standing on the side of the pool, Mr. Robinson hit and kicked Mr. Johnson one time. After retrieving the charger, Mr. Johnson handed it to Mr. Robinson and pulled himself out of the pool to sit on the edge with his feet still in the pool. For some reason, Mr. Johnson didn't leave. You know what I mean? While Mr. Johnson was sitting on the edge of the pool, Mr. Robinson took a swing at Mr. Johnson's face and then began punching and kicking him. Mr. Johnson attempted to escape the pool deck into the hot tub, where Mr. Robinson caught him and attempted to hold Mr. Johnson's head underwater, attempted to drown the motherfucker. Mr. Johnson managed to writhe away, and at this point, two of the bystanders in the pool area ineffectively attempted to intervene before returning to their pool chairs to continue drinking and watching the incident unfold. Of course, World Star, they were probably recording the shit. Shit's probably on World Star right now. You know these people. Let's just call it what it is. Mr. Robinson continued to pace around the hot tub, attempting to hit and kick Mr. Johnson, who retreated to the middle of the hot tub like a little bitch. Mr. Robinson threw a chair at Mr. Johnson, then removed his belt and tried to whip Mr. Johnson with it. This motherfucker, you see what we got here, right? He then proceeded to throw several empty beer bottles at Mr. Johnson. Mr. Johnson eventually emptied his pockets and jumped into, I mean, Mr. Robinson eventually emptied his pockets and jumped into the hot tub, at which point Mr. Johnson got out of the tub and tried to run away. God damn, what kind of bitch is this? Dude has already smacked him and shit, tried to duck his head under the water. He ran into a column. This motherfucker gets out the tub, tries to run away, and runs into a column, falls down. Mr. Robinson proceeds to hit and kick Mr. Johnson while he was on the ground, of course, aiming several kicks at his head. The bystanders finally intervene, and Mr. Johnson was able to escape. The entire episode, from the time Mr. Robinson initially hit and kicked Mr. Johnson and to when Mr. Johnson escaped, lasted approximately 8 minutes. Mr. Johnson then went to the Pullman Police Department, who checked the security camera and found all this shit. The state originally charged Mr. Robinson with one count of second-degree assault, alleged three alternative means, blah, blah, blah. He got a few charges with this. You hear the story. So that's evidence right there that he, by the way, he got 15 months in prison for this. So Mr. Tyrone Demetrius, he went to prison for 15 months for this. This is in 2018. So he gets out in 2018. He gets out in, not 2018, that would be 2019, whenever the fuck he got out. And then we get more. Tacoma man charged with choking Pullman woman. A woman declined to unlock her phone and was allegedly choked for it. Demetrius R. Robinson, age 34, of Tacoma, is charged with assault in the second degree, assault in the fourth degree, unlawful imprisonment, and harassment. Threats to kill in Whitman County Superior Court. He was booked into jail around 3:15 on Monday. This is in, by the way, 2021. This is in 2021. And appeared to be under the influence of a stimulant and as he was acting excited and not forming sentences, according to court records. We'll keep going. The Washington State University police arrested Robinson. Keep that in mind. The Washington State University police arrested Robinson at the Residence Inn by the Marriott. They were called by staff after a 19-year-old woman claimed she was assaulted in a hotel room. Police noted they photographed red marks on her neck and arms. The woman said she and Robinson are acquaintances and had sex before he left the hotel room for several hours. He had to go make a dope run. After he returned, she was texting when he said, "Hey, bitch, give me the phone." He demanded her phone. She locked it and denied it, which means she was on some bullshit. We all know that, right? Robinson is accused of getting angry, choking the shit out the broad, and telling her, "I'll fucking kill you." According to court records, he told her to leave, and when she tried, he allegedly grabbed her from behind to stop her. He let her go and then grabbed her hair in the hall and hit her in the face. Officers wrote that they had had consensual sex and argued over the locked phone and declined to say anything further, according to court records. So that's the issue there. You see what we're getting here, right? Now, suspect in UI spring break death has a criminal history. We're still talking about Demetrius Robinson. So here's what we got. Robinson, we already know that the young man, his name was Caden Young. That's the man that they sold the drugs to that killed him. Caden Young was just in case you didn't know, he is literally the president, a past president of the Alpha Kappa Lambda fraternity at the University of Idaho. Just wanted you to know, he's literally one of the fraternity's presidents. Was. Young was found dead by a friend in a Satiria apartment. Okay, we know all that. Okay. All right, this is not Robinson's first time in jail. According to Whitmer County Prosecutor Dennis Tracy, Robinson has been involved in a number of Whitman County cases over the past 6 years. Most notably, he committed second-degree assault in 2018, was sentenced to 15 months in prison. He was investigated for a possible charge of second-degree rape. Second-degree rape in 2020. At the alleged victim's request, no charge was filed. Let that sink in. So we got battery. We got attempted strangulation. We then got rape. Let's continue on. Where we at here? He was arrested in March 2021 on suspicion of possession of controlled substances with intent to deliver. That means drug dealing, and with assaulting his companion at the time. We just talked about that one as well. Tracy stated that the evidence in the drug case turned to be unusable in court due to problems in the search of the hotel room, and that charge of possession was dismissed. The assault case resulted in Robinson pleading guilty in 2021, the fourth degree assault into harassment. He got 151 days only in jail. That's for that shit he did with the chick. Robinson had 5 misdemeanor charges of driving on suspended license in 2017, for which he was sentenced to 5 days in jail following a plea deal. He was then charged with driving on suspended and driving without a valid ID in February. He did not show up for court, and there is an arrest warrant out for Robinson in that case. Let that sink in. He had a warrant at the time of this death of this kid. So that's a little bit of information on his past. By the way, he did reach a plea deal with assaulting and threatening a woman at a WSU hotel. He did reach a plea deal for that day, for that case, in which he got 1 year of unsupervised probation and ordered him to pay $1,500 in fines and court costs. So, just so you know, those are some of his past. Now, we're going to look at a whole lot of different shit here. Because something I want you guys to understand, if you look on social media, this is actually him. He goes by the name Mr. Proper Motivation. Believe it or not, on social media, he does not go by his name at all. He does not go by his name at all. Mr. Proper Motivation is him right here. But if you look at his Facebook and you click on it, it takes you to Anthony Ombre. So this is him here, Anthony Ombre. Now, there's not a lot you can gather from here other than pictures here and there. You can see some pictures of the man. But that is who we are talking about. So to gather a little bit of his social media, you just take a look down his Twitter timeline. Now, this is where Emma Bailey will eventually come in. Because at some point, him and Emma Bailey have connected. And Emma Bailey is basically being, in my opinion, pimped out by this dude. We'll talk a little bit about that, but she's doing modeling. You know how the Instagram models are. And you know how these people think they are. Dude right here thinks he's bigger than what he is, and you'll clearly see it in quite a different things. Now, his pinned tweet right here from November 9th, 2022, only a couple days before this. Diary of a Dope Baby is what he's calling it. Find that extremely interesting. Diary of a Dope Baby.
Young boy, what's his name? What does he go by?
Mr. Proper fucking Motivation. Let me say it again for you in slow motion. Mr. Proper Motivation, the best motivation.
Mr. Proper Motivation.
Young.
Diary of a Dope Baby. It's almost too funny, really, but it's also sad. So anyway, let's take a listen to him here. Let's see what he's got to say here.
Sand to the beach, open-minded my freaks, yes, getting rich with bikini bottom seat. Sandy got cheeks, you looking Krabby Patty, but the bag thicker than that man name. So frisky, is your duck funny? Gangsta spinning, we school mainline. Call you BB Buffy, you be
stuck. Ain't it kind of funny how sometimes a pimp also looks gay as fuck too? You know what I'm saying? But clearly, that's what he is. And there's a lot of examples of this. You can scroll down here, and I'll show you some things here. He does a lot of promoting for clubs and things of this nature. But this is him, trapping on Alki. Just understand, he wanted to be something. We'll get to that. Now, you'll see him act like he's a star, but I'm going to show you something big here in a minute. So basically, he's a promoter. Now, as we scroll down, there's some big things I really wanted you to see, okay? So that box hit different. So he does obviously make some music, and he thinks he's going to be big, but I want you to see something right here. Mr. Proper Motivation retweeted this right here from Bespoke Post. I want you to see this, because when you look at this ad, is there anything there that sticks out to you? Serious question, is there anything there that sticks out to you? Why is reparations trending? Fuck your reparations. Anyways, is there anything in this picture that sticks out to you? Just kind of curious. Don't you find that a little ironic? Don't you find that a little ironic? Does it not look to you like he's like, this don't seem a little odd to you? But anyway, whatever. I noticed that stuck out to me. Really strange that really strange to me. But anyway, look, man, he doesn't get in. Nobody watches him. I just wanted to say this. All that showing off, and for 28 days, he had 749 views. And that was 579 more than usual. So that's all I wanted to say in regards to that. So he's not, it's all flash. There's nothing there. But I am showing you this because a lot of these posts, there she is right there. There's Emma Bailey right there. The force you should follow. There's Emma right there. Now, when you click on Emma Pure, it goes to Emma Bailey. Oddly enough, Emma Bailey did not start her Twitter, at least here, until December of 2022. Make that make sense, right? Make that make sense. So you clearly see, there's Emma right there. Emma and him work together, looking, doing photographs, same building, same everything. Now, I'm showing you this. Why am I showing you this? This is all adding up. We're getting somewhere. So clearly there's the connection with Emma Bailey. All right? So there, Emma Bailey and him clearly are in a work/romance relationship. Different names, but Emma also has her YouTube channel right here. Something I wanted to show you. What do you notice about this? What do you guys notice about these eyes? What do you notice about those eyebrows? Say it with me, people. Those are bushier than a motherfucker, ain't they? Hold on, JB, what are you saying? That's some bushy-ass eyebrows. Remember, this is Maddie's. This is someone that was best friends with Maddie's old roommate that lived, and I'll show you where they live. Trust me. All right. Now, I don't want to show you too much of her public records, but what I will show you is this. She lived exactly 3 minutes because she lived on a street called Shetland Court. She lived exactly 3 minutes, 0.9 miles away from the murder house. How could that be, JB? Oh, it is. We're not done yet, though. But I just wanted you to see. Look at the eyebrows. Demetrius, we've already seen, is a violent little Tyrone. Now, let's go ahead. We've shown you their connection clearly. We have shown you their connection, and we can even go to her Facebook, I believe, here. If you look on her Facebook, she's got a lot of pictures, a lot of modeling pictures. That's clearly what she wants to do. She's supposedly a model, and he's her manager. I saw screenshots on Lana's Truth and Transparency's video on this. But I want to show you a couple things. I do want to say, I'm not a big fan of JLR, but he is the one that got me down this rabbit hole. There's some other things I want to show you regarding this. So we've established she lives close to him, 3 minutes away. We have established that basically she is best friends with Ashlyn Couch, which is Maddie's old roommate, I believe. When Brian Koberger got arrested, he clearly asked, did anybody else get arrested? And so I'm not necessarily exonerating Brian Koberger with this. But what I'm doing is simply showing you that there is a connection here, a connection I'm very, very curious about. Now, I want to show you here where I wrote it down, 135. Something that JLR said that I wanted to show you guys something. Because I wanted to prove this to you.
Dash driver.
Hold on.
And I kept
hold on
that she was a
hold on, here we go. Say it again.
What I do know about Emma Bailey is her mom has confirmed with me that she was a DoorDash driver.
Emma Bailey's mother has confirmed with JLR that she was a DoorDash driver. Now, in a previous video, it was revealed in phone call conversations with Jack in the Box that the driver was a female with dark hair. Didn't I tell you that who's to say that a female with dark hair didn't have someone else in the car, like Tyrone up there? Now, I'm saying this to you because I initially told you I don't understand why more people aren't focused on. The only person we know for sure that was at that property at 4 a.m. was the DoorDash driver. Now, let me ask you a question. If we were to find out that Emma Bailey was the DoorDash driver at that house, would that change your opinion? Would that change your opinion on this entire story? Can you truly look at Demetrius Robinson and say you would be surprised if him and Emma didn't do this? Now I want to show you something else here, because it ain't all that JLR said. JLR's got some other information. I got some other shit I want to show you. Now, this is body cam footage from one of the nights that there was parties at that house. Watch this.
Let's go make
contact.
Watch this. How goes it?
Oh, hey, how are you?
Now, chick on the left.
Lives here.
Look at the chick on the left. And look at the chick on the right. Now I'm going to show you something else. Let's actually look at Emma Bailey getting pulled over.
The reason we're chatting is running the red light.
Look at the chick in the driver's seat, Emma Bailey. She got arrested that night for DUI. I got the body cam footage and all that of her entire arrest. But that's her right there. Look at the chick that's in the passenger seat. Let's go back to this. I'm gonna give you a chance to tell me what y'all think.
How goes it?
Don't that look a lot like the same two bitches at the murder house? I could be wrong. I genuinely could. But as this Twitter user said, this is, by the way, there's body cam footage of this. That's her in jail. Look at them big ass eyebrows. Your eyebrows are bigger than my dick, lady. Your eyebrows are, what the fuck is that? Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know who has done what. But I do know that until now, I have not seen any other actual potential suspects. But I want to lay this on the line. We see the bit bushy eyebrows. We all believe drugs could be involved. I'm not exonerating Koberger here, even though I don't think Koberger did it. But I do find it interesting that when Brian Koberger got arrested, he said, did anybody else get arrested? Well, a lot of us believe the fact that she was a DoorDash driver, according to her mother, and then Jack in the Box said a chick with black hair was the DoorDash driver. And then just a fucking week ago, I was telling you, what if the DoorDash driver had her boyfriend with her? These people are like Bonnie and Clyde right now. Ever since this dude came into her life, she's been going to jail. Now she's facing 10 years. Dude's been beating people up and assaulting people and hurting people a long fucking time. So if you want to ask me, do I believe Brian Koberger did it? I'm supposed to believe that Brian Koberger, a PhD student, did it, but not look into Tyrone here? Not look into Demetrius? Get the fuck out of here. I don't often give JLR shout-outs, but appreciate his work because he's the one that sent me down this rabbit hole and I've been doing research on it all fucking night. Now, is there anything that specifically connects them? No. But it's just circumstantial, just like Koberger shit. The fact that Emma knew was best friends with his best friends with Ashlyn Couch, who was Maddie's old roommate, right? The fact that she only lived 3 minutes away from the house, that footage looks like her there. Is it possible that these two drug dealers were perhaps delivering drugs as well? Or maybe they got there, delivered the DoorDash, and old Tyrone right there was like, man, I'm gonna hit a lick. I'm gonna hit a lick, baby. Ask yourselves that. I think I got a new target I'm looking at. Guys, I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time. Let me know what you think about this. This is just my theories on this situation. Let me know what you guys think, though. You guys know where I stand. I just don't think they got Koberger. And seeing this shit, I'm just going to be honest with you. I'm curious about it. Because it fits, doesn't it? It fits. It makes sense to me. What do y'all think? If you like what I do here and you want to support the channel, feel free to hit the links down below. Sorry, man. I got this fucking sciatic nerve dealing with some shit right now. This is your video for today, though. I'm going to get this up to you as soon as possible. You guys have a good one. I'm JB Gunner. This is Crime Time. Peace out.